Good morning. This is your personal sensei for Tuesday, June 23rd, 2015. Well, today is a two-part day, and frankly, every day is a two-part day here through most of the summer in North America. This crashing sea behind me is very appropriate for a lot of what we're about to experience. The next 3 to 4 days will be in high tide of emotion, all right? This high tide is to get us really to understand exactly what our feelings are. A lot of us spend the year ignoring our feelings. A lot of us spend the year not talking about our feelings. And so when the sun moves into Cancer, this is the high tide of emotion. This is when it all comes to the surface. Sometimes it just needs to come to the surface so it can be recognized and released. Sometimes it isn't as big of a deal as you might think before it starts to come up, or as you think before you start to feel it. So thoughts are one thing, feelings are another. And we have to deal with our feelings about things, even if our mind is already raced ahead, even if our soul already understands, even if the wisdom is already there, you still have to deal with your feelings separately as a separate animal of being a human being. All right? So today, the tides are high, and the tides are going to rise just a bit today. So today, things will feel very, very sensitive. That has to do with where the moon is in its cycle in Libra, so we're extremely sensitive. You're going to feel your feelings go back and forth, and you are here to sense out precisely how you feel about certain things. And that brings up really today's phrase of the day. Today I feel my truths, and that's okay. Today I feel my truths, and that's okay. So basically, we want to program the mind today to feel our truths and to be okay with whatever they are. So it's like, you know what? I feel like I want to kill her. That's okay. You know what I mean? Like, that's okay. Everything that you feel is okay. And that's the first thing to do. We want to let reality flow through us here. We don't want to be in denial. And I mentioned this yesterday, and I'll keep mentioning this. You know, the sun in Cancer, I think people who get Cancer are people who often ignore their feelings, and their body eventually can't take anymore and starts to break down. So in the next 2-3 days, if a person has been ignoring their feelings, they're going to feel that breakdown. So today, we want to let that all loose, and we want to plan with our mind to allow our feelings to flow freely. So one more time to keep it in the mind. I feel my truths today, and that's okay. And so it is, because I said so. I thought so. So today, you want to allow your feelings to flow, and because of the sensitivity of the moon, your feelings may feel like they're going out of control to the left or they're going out of control to the right, all right? And my advice is to not oversteer, okay? Not oversteer. So if it looks like your marriage is crashing for destruction, don't help it, okay? Don't oversteer the situation. It's kind of like if you find yourself moving 80 miles an hour down a U.S. highway and you find yourself in the shoulder, you don't oversteer the car to get it back in. You just gently let the car come back into the road, okay? Because when you oversteer at a certain velocity, you can flip the car. Same thing with today, all right? You're going to feel super sensitive. You're going to feel like the whole world could come crashing down at any second. That is actually your ability to destroy it if you wanted to, okay? So what you want to do is just very calmly, just kind of slowly bring yourself back, okay, and keep yourself calm today. So that brings us to today's joy question. You choose to accept it. Your joy question, you choose to accept it is, row, row, row your boat. You like that? Gently down the stream, merrily, merrily, merrily. Now, I brought that up for a super big reason. One, it goes all the way back to your childhood, in like, you know, age 2 and younger, so that's good. It's something that you can kind of put in your head. But really, I bring it up because it's a nursery rhyme that is apropos for the sun in Cancer. I don't care what you're feeling, just keep rowing your boat forward. Okay, so it's like, oh, mucky waters, ooh, cold water, you know what I mean? Ooh, pirates, you know what I mean? Just keep rowing your boat. You just keep rowing. That's one of the secrets I have learned with emotion is when emotion stops flowing, it starts to breed dis-ease, all right? That's what I talked about here in the beginning of this personal sensei. And when emotion is something you don't like, you can't just oversteer it and expect it to turn around in your favor. You have to just keep moving. So like piloting a boat, if anyone's ever driven a boat, you can't just turn the boat really fast this way or turn the boat really fast that way, and you can't just stop a boat on a dime. You have to decide way ahead of time that you should glide and stop putting energy into it and let it come to a glide and stop. And that's really how you have to manage emotions, in my experience. So today, to be in the most control of the boat on this ocean of emotion, all right, you just want to keep rowing, rowing, rowing the boat. And I bring up this cute little nursery rhyme because you will not forget it. Row, row, row your boat gently down the stream. And keep rowing it, okay, for about 4 days. I'll tell you when to stop. All right, so row, row, row your boat. Now, one last thing. I do want to leave you with a little bit of chakra work each day. So I will do, of course, a little bit of our chakras. Let's leave the day with some spiritual calisthenics and our chakras. All right, so looking at the chakras, they're important because they are color conscious points of focus. And right now we are focused way on the yellow, okay? So yellow is where it's hyper focused. You want to do some extra breathing through your solar plexus the entire time we are in the sun in Cancer. So if you can do 3 breaths through the front and 3 breaths through the back, you visualize it going down through the crown and out through the front, down through the crown and out through the back, okay? At least 3 and 3. You want a perfect world? Do 12 and 12. All right, that's one for each state of awareness that clears it. That's kind of how it's wired. And do that breathing. The other thing I will bring up with all this yellow is today's step one rules today. So we're in our heart, and our heart is a big part of what's guiding us forward. So we're rowing our boat, but where are we going? We're following the heart. The heart is our chest, our heart chakra. So open your heart, open your chest. Breathe into that space, okay, and keep rowing your boat. All right. So that moves on to today's telepathy, your final spiritual calisthenic. As you can see, I'm kind of regrouping things. And this spiritual calisthenic is designed to help you learn your intuition. And I know from doing thousands of readings now that if you do it every day, you get damn good at it. You get really fluent with yourself. So this is a little exercise you can do. And when we skip over to the Zodiac weather file, you will have the answer at the beginning of the top of that for today's telepathy. So we're moving on to Cancers and Cancer personalities. And in today's telepathy, I am looking at family-driven business moguls. So Cancers are known for making a lot of money, and it's true. They can manifest a lot of money because they appeal to emotion. As you watch this week and this whole month, I'll be teaching you about how emotion is the secret to abundance. So these are Cancer family-driven moguls, but only one of these moguls I am thinking about right now and sending from my temple to yours an extra sparkly. Which of these moguls am I thinking of? Is it number one, Cancer Elon Musk? Is it number two, Cancer J.D. Rockefeller? Or is it number three, Cancer Alexander the Great? Which one of those Cancer moguls am I thinking of? I'll have the answer in your Zodiac weather. Why can't you find love? How long have you really been single? Really? Having trouble finding that special soulmate? I can solve this one. Secrets of Birthdays, now live for purchase. Your love trouble? Over. All that and more at secretsofbirthdays.com.